game between the Miami Hurricanes and the Florida State Seminoles. And, of course, we look here at our Star Watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
I'm going to keep an eye on those young athletes at the point guard position. Not only are they skilled, but provide their teams with what they need.
Time for the tip-off.
Play ball, baby. Play ball as Ebert tosses it up.
And we're underway. Trying to pack it inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed it. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The Seminoles running their zone offense here, Dick.
Well, I'll tell you what, Brad, the zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people...
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
And back they come the other way. On the dribble, gives it up. For two, he gets it to go.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
A little two-man action. For the bucket, he shows the sweet touch. And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work. Up and inside.
And up. And in and out. That was nice. Goes up and come up short. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Dumps it in. He shoots from the deep corner. Perfectly executed. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. They work it around the perimeter. Unloads. Off the mark. The Seminoles running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
The Hurricanes with the push. He shoots from the corner. Gets the J to fall. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. Gave it up with a deep shot from outside. Can't connect. Loose ball and batted in. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Off the inbound. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Missed the jumper. Going to move it around the perimeter. He attempts the three and score it. He fires it up. And he missed. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
The point guard gets the pass. The Seminoles go into their zone motion now. On the left side. Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three. Scores it. Goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking for a good shot. He puts up the three ball. He buries the jumper. Takes the jumper. Knocks it down. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot. Look at that spacing.
He shoots the jumper. Nope. Bacon handles the pass. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. They'll work it around the arc. About 10 seconds left on the shot clock. It to beat the clock. They got it. Here comes the ball screen. Number one is called for the foul. First team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, he's just a freshman, eh? We all got to start somewhere.
Well, he's out there seeing a lot of this for the first time. It's going to be important that he gets the right direction and guidance from his teammates and coaching staff.
Misses it. He takes the board. Work the perimeter. Goes up for two. He gets that one to fall.
Wow, the defense is doing a great job of fighting through screens to deny easy looks at the baskets, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Puts up the J. Busts the jumper. Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Tries for two. That one's off. Tickles a twine. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the left side, from the corner, perfectly executed. The Seminoles running their zone offense here, Dick.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, they really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Cross court. He takes a three. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. Zone motion now. The crowd begins to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
It sticks. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
Well, he spotted an opening, and he just absolutely great first step, and he exploded to the goal. Hey, Brad, he finishes this one off the transition.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
There it is, Jam City.
Getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
Cross court. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Missed it. Number 22 gets the ball. The Seminoles go into their zone motion now. Working it around the perimeter. Throws it up.
There's the off.
And a shot block.
Oh, he's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high-riser.
The shooting guard takes the pass with the J. And scoring. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
They work it around the perimeter. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
And now they'll bring it up. Down inside. In the lane. Missed the jumper. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For two, scorches the net. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Miller manages to keep it in. Did the guy in the stands call for it?
So many teams get bumped on screens when you inbounds the ball from the baseline.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I'd say it just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jump and the block. The Seminoles set up in their zone motion, and we're at the 8-minute mark. Cross court.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
They go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
And come up short. The Seminoles set up into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Off the mark.
Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little Baryshnikov in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. They wanted an offensive interference call and don't get it. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Trying to go inside.
For the bucket. Jumper won't go. Into their zone motion now. We're at the 6-minute mark. Cross court. Goes up for two. Sinks the shot. From 3-point land. Scores it. Getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Moving it around the perimeter. There's a slam.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best. That ball movement, get that good spacing.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. On the outside. He goes for three. Knocked it down. Bacon receives the ball. Bacon, slowly performance, has just gotten in his head.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
He attempts the jump shot. Gets the J to fall. And the jam. Great strength on that drive.
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong.
We're at the 4-minute mark. Looking for a good shot. From way outside. Nope. He gets the board. Zone motion now. Cross court. Shoots from outside. Off the mark. Gave it up. Goes up with a shot. Scorches the net with a J. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the left side. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. An errant pass out of bounds for the turnover.
Well, you credit that to two factors. One, great team defense, but number two, lack of communication offensively, not in rhythm and sync.
The baseline inbounds. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Number four receives the ball.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Perfectly executed. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility, who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
He pulls up with a jumper. The missed shot. Out on the wing. Blocked. We'll get a change of possession. So the inbound play on the baseline. There's a bad pass right to the defender. Now looking to attack. The Seminoles move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the dribble, gives it up from the corner. They get it to go.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. The Seminoles now running a zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
That's good. About a minute remaining. Brown receives the pass. He goes up with it. Busts the J. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Shoots it. Perfectly executed. Shot clock is dead. Jumper, and nice looking jumper in the lane. He tries the jumper, knocked it down. With the big shot, and come up short. Time, the Seminoles are up by four. Florida State is showing some deadly accuracy from the field in the first half.
Hey, for sure, Brad. This kind of accuracy can easily be carried over to the second half if they continue to be patient with the lock. Patience and poise usually equals points. We'll be right back.
going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Gave it up. From the corner. Off the mark. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Cross court. For two, he gets it to fall.
That's battledore defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
On the outside. For the bucket. Knocks it down. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the right side. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from downtown.
Nope.
Number 22 takes the feed. Zone motion now.
Up and inside.
He bombs from outside. Nails a sweet jumper. Top of the key. They're working around the perimeter. He goes for three. Missed the jumper. Cross court.
Silly mistake.
They go into the low block. He puts up the J. Gets the J to fall. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The Hurricanes are going into their zone motion offense now. He tries the fadeaway. He misses the fadeaway. The Seminoles go into their zone motion now. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Sinks it. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Number 22 receives the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Great shot. Receives the ball. They got it. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And it's
the layup's good and one, Dick.
Hey, that's good concentration. Taking the ball hard to the hoop. Knowing that someone's going to have to. Those seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
He got it. They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Gave it up. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. The Seminoles are going into their zone motion offense now. Looking for a good shot. for two. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots the jumper. Nails the J. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Ball's going to stay here. Baseline inbounds. He hammers it home. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 22 takes it away. Here they go in transition. The Seminoles go into their... That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
They'll work it around the arc. He tries the three ball. Bust the J. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
They work the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. Knocks it down. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For two, he's money with the shot. They look to get it to the inside for the bucket. No. He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Mr. Excitement with that jam.
Gave it up. He unloads a three. And score it. Trying to feed inside. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Gets it to fall. And a momentary look from three-point land. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Working it around the perimeter.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
They work it around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Goes up for two. He nails the shot. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Nails the sweet jumper.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Bust the jumper. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I love the floor of round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Reed picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
First shot, no good. Rims off, gets the board.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
On the outside. Bad decision there by the freshman. The Seminoles here running their zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, man. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
On the right side. For the bucket. Oh, yes. They go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
The Seminoles are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
Anytime you get a player in the high post, you put pressure on the defense, and that can lead to big breaks over the course of the game.
Missed the jumper. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. He hits the shot. Inside. Tries a three. He misses the fadeaway.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
And now, getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, the four round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense. Nice low post play, good entry to the box.
Off the mark.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. The Seminoles are going into their zone motion offense now. Dumps it in. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Around 8 minutes remaining. Feed the low post. Tries for two. Scores it. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
The Hurricanes might be in some trouble here, Dick. They're going to have to put the pedal to the metal and really look to attack offensively to get some baskets.
Offensively and defensively, it's definitely time to be aggressive. Playing in the full court is what they do well, so they may be in a position to get back into this game.
He makes the jumper. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. On the outside. Number number 50 is charged with... He gets the foul and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
Steps to the line for the freebie. He hits it. They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
Fed the low block. He attempts a jump shot. Gets the J to fall. The Hurricanes are going into their zone motion offense now.
Up and inside.
Had his shot rejected. Perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails the jumper. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He attempts the trifecta. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One-on-one.
They work it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. Scorches the net with a J. Looking for a good shot. He launches a three. And score it. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
In the paint, number 50 with the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes his first.
Those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Ball stripped. Top of the circle, they work it. And it's blocked. Lays it up.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. He drains the bucket. Teams will play all sorts of tempos and styles these days, Dick. What are some of the characteristics of up-tempo teams?
Up-tempo teams typically have some great athletes, people that can really get out in transition, who really can run exceptionally well, and also can jump exceptionally well.
The Seminoles set up in their zone motion. About 4 minutes remaining in the game clock.
Turnover by the freshman.
Reed handles the feed. They'll work it around the arc. Turnaround jumper. Missed it. Bacon handles the pass.
Terrific score off the fast break.
Goes up for two. Busts the J. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Three minutes left on the game clock. on the left side. He tries the three. Nails the J. They work the perimeter. Turnover committed by the senior. And a momentary look from three-point land. And the fans here are loving the action.
It's electrifying in here.
Zone offense now. Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. It's good. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. His bad. Points of the paint are huge, and these guys have really been coming up big in that category.
Hey, now they've established things in the paint. Look for the perimeter players to have some openings. It's been great to see how they've been able to rack up points in the paint.
Inbound from the baseline. And it's knocked loose. The Seminoles going to their zone motion now. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get fifth.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
On the left side. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Can't connect. Bacon handles the pass. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
1 minute left on the game clock. Here's the inbound play on the baseline. Now, getting set up here in a four-around-one.
I tell you, the four-around-one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Change of possession. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
With a quarterback pass from the corner, perfectly executed. Shot clock is dead. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. Nope. On the dribble, gives it up. He throws it up from downtown. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Moving it around the perimeter. Florida State was caught in quite a battle tonight before pulling ahead for good.
But two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.